Hello and welcome to Ask Phill number 13. Unlucky for some, not unlucky for us. Today we're going to talk about feather loss in chickens. Quite important this time of the year, obviously it's cold, but we've had quite a few phone calls from mainly ladies saying that their birds are a bit bare, and with it being cold weather, they're very worried about them. So we thought we'd have a little chat about feather loss and the reasons in chickens. So the number one reason for birds losing their feathers this time of year is, of course, moulting. Now, moulting happens towards the tail end of the year, where the days get shorter because the hen's body reacts to the amount of light, the length of light in the day, and it sheds its feathers starting from the neck and basically working down. So when you see late summer, early autumn, your birds going around with bare necks, they've started moulting, and it works through their body, and eventually the last ones to be replaced are normally the tail feathers. Now, all birds are different, they're like people. Some birds will moult within about 2 weeks. They'll be running around naked as a jaybird for about 2 weeks, and then all of a sudden they'll feather up and come back into lay, and you'll have a lovely pristine looking chicken. Other birds can take months, and it's generally the most vigorous birds, your best laying hens, that will moult in the shortest period of time, because they are the most vigorous, they've got the most energy, they're up and at them, and so they'll change their coat quicker. So if you've got a bird that's taking a long time to moult, you can probably say it's either old or infirm because of illness or something like that. Number two reason is good old stress. Our chickens are very, very vulnerable to stress, being birds. They're very wary, very easily stressed. Not relevant now, but in the summer, if you've got poor ventilation in your houses, they will shed their feathers for overheating, especially during the night. Hot summer's nights, lack of ventilation, your birds will lose their feathers. Stress, bullying, and lack of water. Again, that's a stress issue, but your bird will lose its feathers through lack of water. The other reason that the bird, you'll think, oh, look at this bird, it's got a bare chest, there's no feathers in it. It's probably going broody, and so it's going to pull its own chest feathers out so that it can get its bare skin next to the egg to raise the temperature and the humidity. So that's a very common thing. Keep your eye out in the summer, late spring, summer, bare-chested chickens, they're going broody. Third reason is pecking of the feathers from other birds or by the bird itself. They will actually peck their own feathers out sometimes. Now, this is due to bullying, which is caused by lack of space, too many birds, an aggressive bird. There's normally a bullier, there's normally a feather pecker that starts it all. Feathers are made of keratin, and keratin is addictive to birds. So once they start pecking feathers, they tend to carry on doing it. When the new feathers are coming through after the moult, they come through in a sheath. So they're called pin feathers, and they come through in a sheath. Inside that sheath is a blood supply. And so if another bird pecks the pin feathers of a bird, they'll cause blood to flow. Immediate attraction to chickens just gets them to do it more and more. You also tend to get, during the winter months, more nighttime pecking. Now, you'll notice pecking that happens at night tends to happen more on the rear end of birds, what they call sweet feathers around the vent, because they're quite soft and downy. Because they're on the perches, they're longer on the perches, they're bored at night, they're in there for hours on end, and they'll just peck the feathers from the bird in front of them. Which again, once they start, difficult to stop them. The main thing you can do to help this is watch your birds. If you see that you have a particular bird that's being aggressive and pecking the feathers of other birds, remove her from the flock for a week or 2 weeks. And that'll put her right down the chain of dominance, down the pecking order. So when she comes back in again, she shouldn't peck the other birds. If anything, the other birds will peck her, but things will even out quite quickly after that. Chickens go feather hunting. If you notice, when they're molting, they will tend to pick their own feathers up and eat them. That's the bird recycling all this protein that they've used in their body, because feathers are 80% keratin, which is almost pure protein. So they're protein hunting. So you'll find that if your birds all persistently peck each other's feathers, there's a chance they could just be short of protein in their diet. In which case, we're back again to a good quality layers pellet. If you find that they're still not doing it, you can give your birds some chick crumb, which is a higher protein level again, and that might just help. But the main thing is good quality layers pellets, not too many treats. Fourth most common reason is over mating. Not too much of a problem now, but certainly as you come into spring, early summer, if you've got cockerels, cockerels tend to have a favorite or two within the flock, and they will pay most attention to her or them. And you'll tend to find, because the cockerel will jump on the back of the birds, tread the back of the birds, and hold on to the feathers at the back of the neck, like these feathers, you'll tend to find that the back of the neck there, they'll be bald, and on across the shoulders and down the back of the bird, there'll be a lack of feathers and sometimes some quite serious scratching and that sort of thing. For this, you can get chicken saddles. These go on the back of the chickens, like so, but a bit bigger on me. And that just protects the shoulders of the bird and her back. Now, if you've got one cockerel, two hens, doesn't matter what you do, they're going to get injured. You need six hens at least to go with any decent sized cockerel. What you can do, if you've got a small flock of hens and you're finding that you're getting a lot of cockerel damage and you still want a cockerel, because cockerels are great with a flock of chickens, they really do help stop bullying and this sort of thing, then suggest going for a bantam cockerel, because the pure physicality of a bantam cockerel means that he's not likely to do as much damage. You will, of course, get hybrid chicks, but a lot of people don't actually want chicks anyway. They just want the cockerels there because they're attractive and they do help control the flock. There is one other reason, which we have gone into before, where you're likely to get feather loss, and that is lice and mites. And for that, refer back to Ask Phill video number 3. Which was all about lice in chickens. That tells you how to deal with it, what to use, and all the rest of it. But for now, just with the overall loss of feathers in chickens, there are a number of things that you can do to make it less likely in the winter. Number one, feed a good quality feed. Fancy feeds, copped up meal vermex feeds, small holder, marriages, a good quality feed, not your Tesco's basics. Good quality feed, it will have lots of vitamins, lots of minerals, and a high protein level, because you need protein to make feathers. The other thing you can do is to give them poultry tonics, which contain minerals, vitamins, amino acids, and proteins to help them maintain their plumage and to help regenerate the plumage when they've lost it. Poultry spice as well, good source of vitamins and trace elements. If you've got a problem with pecking, with other birds pecking your birds, then there's several preparations that you can use. There's a Netex anti-feather pecking spray or a barrier anti-pecking spray. Now these are based on Bitterex, which is what you would use to stop you chewing your nails. So they're a nasty, sharp taste. But if you've got determined birds, they will ignore this because they really like the taste of the feathers, in which case you need to resort to one of the good old-fashioned Stockholm tar-based preparations. This is a spray one that's much easier to put on. It's brown, it's smelly, but it does work. So that's something you can use for that. So pretty much keep an eye on your chickens. Watch out for what's causing the feather loss. If you find that after all this you're still having problems, you have to go for a bit of tough love. Stop treats. I know it, but we have found that you get more persistent feather loss with some of our ladies that really, really, really look after their chickens. You know, they make them their own special dinners and pasta and this and that and all the rest of it. You need to take them down to a good quality layers pellet. Feed that, it's got the right protein levels and the right vitamin levels in it. And that stands a much, much better chance of helping your birds, especially through the winter months like now, of maintaining their plumage. Too many treats, you miss out on vitamins and especially protein. So that's about feather loss, really. Thank you very much. That's the end of Ask Phill 13. Please watch next week. Thank you very much indeed. Bye-bye. If you've got any questions for Ask Phill, please email in to info@flightsofancy.co.uk. That's flight with a Y. Or you can go on to our Facebook channel, Flight So Fancy Facebook channel, or our YouTube video channel where all the Ask Phill questions are and loads more videos from Flight So Fancy. If you're interested in any products that have been featured on our videos, please have a look on our website, which is www.flightsofancy.co.uk. And there's lots and lots of information, lots of products, and loads and loads and loads of chicken knowledge that's been garnered over the years. Also, just in case you're not on the internet, I'm not quite sure how you're watching this, but we also do a printed catalogue as well, which is we're just printing this year's now. So thank you very much indeed for watching. Bye-bye.